Hello there. Let's talk about PICO. Firstly, what is PICO? It's a tool used in medical research to help ensure that researchers ask good questions, and can be helpful as well if you're doing a structured literature search. Each of the letters in PICO, P, I, C and O, stands for one thing which should be included in a well-structured clinical question. P stands for patient or population. Who is it that you want to learn about? It could be teenagers with elevated blood pressure, patients in an intensive care unit, early onset dementia patients. I stands for intervention. What action are you looking at the effects of? It could be a drug or a therapy or perhaps a health promotion campaign. C stands for comparison. What else are you comparing that intervention to, if anything? And O stands for outcome. Why was the intervention carried out? Accurate diagnosis or reduction of a symptom, for instance. PICO is very much focused on research into interventions, but one variation which can be useful in some other circumstances makes I stand for interest, as in what are you interested in, and C stand for context. Where is this happening, whether that's a geographic area or a healthcare setting such as the emergency department? Let's take a quick look at an example. With teenagers in full-time education, are whole class teaching sessions more effective than educational leaflets in improving dietary choices? In this case, P is the population, teenagers in full-time education. I is the intervention, whole class teaching sessions. C is the comparison, educational leaflets. And O is the outcome, improved dietary choice. Using PICO is one way to make sure that the question you ask in research is clear and helpful without the possibility of being vague or unanswerable. It does this by prompting you to check that key elements of a question are included. You can also make use of PICO when you structure a literature search. By ensuring that your search covers the relevant PICO elements, you build a search which reflects your question closely. You would take each of the elements, P, I, C and O, and make sure that your search covers them all, either with your search keywords or with how you narrow your search down. When you search, you'd take the relevant element from PICO and search for words which relate to it. If the patient element related to cancer, for example, you would probably include words like oncology in your search as well, even if they're not technically in your question. This helps to ensure that you find as much of the relevant literature as possible. For some things, you might not be able to search directly, but you'd make sure that you keep them in mind when you select your articles. The best way to do this is to make sure that you read the abstracts of the articles and think back to those elements of your question. How well does the abstract reflect the P, the I, the C, and the O? So PICO can help you to structure your research questions and help ensure that your searches cover everything you need them to. As always, get in contact with your librarian if you want to know more.